Hi, today's tutorial is on how to set up some free virus protection software on your Mac. If you go to the App Store, and that's that little icon that has an A on it, right in your dock, and you look for a program called ClamXAV, you will be able to download it for free. It's a free application. You simply would click on this little icon, and it would download it. Once it's completed downloading, you'll find it in your Applications folder right here, and you would simply open it up. As soon as you open it up, it's going to ask you, do you want to download the latest virus definitions before continuing? And of course you do, because you want the latest and greatest of the virus definitions, because that's what protects you from the viruses. And as you can see, it's downloading it right now. It may take a while. And as you can see, it's updating my virus definitions at this point. Once you have this, you can set up some preferences on how you want to use this particular program. You can have an alert if it detects a virus. You can have an alert if it does a scan completion. It can animate a dock icon. And update viruses on definitions on launch is always a good thing to turn on, because you definitely want the latest and greatest. It'll protect your computer throughout the week, throughout the year. It can also scan email content for malware and phishing. You may want that on, you may not. That's up to you. I think it's always good to have it on. You might want to set a quarantine folder, which is where the computer can put files that it wants to quarantine. You can put it in your documents folder and call it, bad files if you want. It doesn't really matter. And you hit create and open, and that will set a place for it to quarantine certain files that it finds viruses on, so you can evaluate it and decide for yourself. There's some files that you can exclude that you don't want it to be checked, and that usually happens when it's creating problems and you want to keep it going fast and not slowing down your computer. You definitely want to log the results, because you can always have that taken a look at, and most importantly, you can schedule it. You can schedule exactly when the virus updates happen. You can do it every day. You could drag items into your inbox to scan a schedule, which you could do here, but I think it's pretty much okay if you do a setting as well. And hit OK, and at that point, you're done. The virus definitions, as you can see, are still updating and may take a while, but when you're done, if let's say you want to take a user folder, you can also start a scan. And what it's doing here is it's actually going through my hard drive and looking to see if it's detected any viruses that are in the system. And if it detects one, at that point it will probably put it in the quarantine folder or do exactly what I might be expected that it should do to keep it safe. So it's starting a scan now, and it's kind of going through it, and as you can see, that's what it's doing. It'll take quite a long time because the hard drives are not small, and it will go through every single file, so we're not going to actually keep the video running for that. But what you can learn a little bit about how to set it up and how to get it started and how to set the preferences. If you want to stop this at any point and have it pick up a little later, you can always pause it and hit continue, and it can check your machine, or you could simply stop it and let it do it automatically. So at this point, it hasn't found any infected files, and obviously it did not go through the whole hard drive, so eventually it will scan this. But this is a great way of having it run and then getting it removed.